Good evening, everyone. This is the this is a Brooklyn High School of the Arts Symphonic Band. Give it another round of applause. That first piece was The Thunder of March by John Philip Sousa, the March King, one of his most famous. The next piece we're going to play is a piece by an English composer, Ralph Vaughan Williams. This piece is Folk Songs from Somerset. It's interesting, in the wind ensemble later on, you'll hear, we're going to play another piece by Vaughan Williams called Sea Songs. And Vaughan Williams originally composed these pieces together to be performed together as part of the suite. He later published them separately. So we're just going to play one part of the suite here and another part of the suite later. So this is Folk Songs from Somerset.
Thank you.
Kelly is still composing music today. He writes a lot of pieces for bands. Some of them are really cool. This one, he says, it's obviously about magic. And he said he had his son in mind when he wrote this piece in Italy. How his son is like, you know, kind of really mischievous and mysterious in a way, but also fun. So this is a piece called Abracadabra Open.
The symphonic band I hold in my hand, they're gold!
Yay, Jamal! So,
I'd like to welcome you all here today. My name is Frank Proudfoot. I'm the Assistant Principal of the Arts. It's my great pleasure to support these students and support these teachers in creating music. And it really is an absolute pleasure. They've been incredibly inspiring, especially over the last couple of years. Many of our underclassmen, they, you know, were without music. Some couldn't even have access to instruments. And for them to have rebounded in the way that they have and to be doing the work that they're doing is truly inspiring. And so I hope you're enjoying yourself tonight. I welcome you all. It's wonderful to have you here. It's been a huge week for the music program here at Brooklyn High School of the Arts. You're going to get to see a couple of other award-winning performances tonight. We had a wonderful concert last night as well, and we're so glad that you're here to join us this evening. The next group that you'll see, before me now, this is our mixed choir, and they are led by the newest member. Thank you. And our next group is on their way up, coming to set up right away. So, and our musicians are being very professional tonight. We appreciate that. So I'd like to take a moment, please, to thank a few people. First of all, the entire staff here at Brooklyn High School of the Arts, all of the teachers, not just the arts teachers, but also our amazing, amazing academic teachers. Often, we are, in order to pull off these performances, we're taking students out of class for blackout rehearsals and for events outside the building. And the motto of this school, as many of you know, the motto of this school is that this is where arts and academics take center stage, and that balance is a really beautiful, wonderful thing, so we appreciate all that support. I'd like to also thank our principal, Principal Becciano. Let's hear it for him. An amazing musician himself, an incredible leader, and we're so appreciative to him for making this all possible. I'll come out and thank some other folks in just a bit, but now I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Lawrence and the Jazz Band.
What are you doing? I don't know. 9-part suite of the choir history. We're going to feature our lead saxophonist. Based on a book of the rhythm, but if you're not familiar with the book of the rhythm, it's something that was popular in the 60s. After Latin music, So this next composition is Thad Jones' tone poem. We thought it fitting that we dedicate this one to the lives that were lost in Texas this week. And hopefully they can listen to this. Hopefully they can listen to it as well. This one is entitled The Child is Born.
Thank you.
the end.
Thank you.
Congratulations to our jazz band as well. The jazz band has a long and special tradition. Our next group is on their way down now. They'll be coming down for our final choral performance. But the jazz band has a long tradition here. And one of the most special things about this building is the legacy of music that we have here. And let me hear a real loud shout out if you used to be a jazz band player in high school. So it's always so wonderful to see our alumni and know that, you know, the tradition burns bright and there is a wonderful legacy here at Brooklyn High School of the Arts. And continuing that legacy now, we have our Advanced Trouble Choir as led by Mr. Rocco.
to shout out our seniors.
Amazing dance show. show last weekend, which was attended by nearly 1,500 people over the course of 2 nights. An amazing obviously, we've had some amazing drama performances this year, including Rent, as well as Don Trell and Kiss the Sea, which was honored at the Schubert Festival just 2 nights ago. And we're not done, because next week we have our art show, and I hope that you'll all come on June 2nd, which is next Wednesday, to see all of the amazing art in the hallway there unveiled for your enjoyment. And so it's wonderful to know that arts is thriving here still at Brooklyn High School of the Arts. It's wonderful to have all of you here. And I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Hands and to the Wind Ensemble. Oh, wait a minute, I'm going to hand it over to someone else first. Principal Luciano.
Weren't led by the absolute best assistant principal of the arts in the city of New York, Mr. Frank Thompson. I can tell you, I think he makes this his home address at this point. I don't think he goes home anymore. I think he just lives here. He has been with every one of our ensembles and Don Trell that went out to the Schubert Festival. And everything that has happened in or out of the building in the entire year, and he works tirelessly for your kids. So I just want to thank you very much for this hard work. I want to thank all of our students who have done a great job. Even some of them, maybe this was hard for them because, you know, they haven't done it in a minute, right? They haven't been up here, and they haven't, you know, some of our newer students. So this is some great work, and we plan on 2022-2023 being better than ever. So we hope you'll come back and join us soon. And on that note, Mr. Hands, take it away.
Yeah, Marty!
right. That was the other Vaughan Williams piece that goes with the set that we originally composed. Our next piece is called On the Overland Stage to El Paso. This piece that we're going to play along with the Ski Songs and another march we did at NISMO over the weekend, this band also got gold. Here's On the Overland Stage to El Paso by David Wilson. Thank you. had some students do solos at Nesbitt, solo pieces. Whoever did a solo, stand up. Do the Nesbitt solo. Scores, and I just want to point out two. Oscar, you over here got a perfect score on the level. You also had another student that auditioned on level 6, which is the highest level you can play, the highest level of music. And also, if you get a good score on level 6, you're recommended for the Allstate Festival. One of our students got a perfect score on his level. All right, we got a little special treat for you for this next one.
How many of you out there have played Zelda game before? Zelda game before? So, Zelda came into being, and the first game was created in 1986. And I had that game as a kid, and I loved playing it. And the music from the game has become really memorable. The Japanese composer Kondo, I believe? Koji Kondo. He was a jazz and rock guy in Japan at the time in the 80s, but he loved video games that were just emerging then. So he found himself a job with Nintendo, and he was actually the first person to have a job that his sole purpose was to write the music for the video games. And he clunked away on his like little old computer. They had like a basic program like that, and they couldn't get a lot of sounds on it, but he really enjoyed the sounds he was able to get for the video games at the time. The themes became iconic. Almost everyone can recognize the Zelda theme now when they hear it, and there's been many, many games since. The original music that Kondo wrote has been performed by world-class orchestras, the Tokyo Philharmonic, the New York Philharmonic, you name it. It's performed all over the world now by full symphony orchestras. We're going to play an arrangement of the 25th Anniversary Symphony of Legend of Zelda. And let me tell you, this is a professional arrangement that any professional orchestra would play. And it's even harder when you play it in the band because they have to transcribe it for band instruments. And these guys are playing in keys that they're not usually used to because it's originally an orchestral score. And they really did an absolutely amazing job with this. So I hope you enjoy. Anniversary Symphony, and I'd like to acknowledge that Justin Harvey is going to help us out on keyboards. And you can't have Zelda without a harp, and that's Abe Granados did the video presentation for us.
All right, hope you enjoyed that one. That was pretty good. All right, we got one more for you. Before we do that one, which is really cool and I love it, I just want to acknowledge some very important people. I've had the pleasure of teaching them for the last 4 years, but they will be leaving us. This will be their last concert, but we're excited to see where they go from here. Seniors, please stand up. Thank you.
Especially the seniors. Seniors are